morning, Brooke here, and I'm with
Rosie.
And we're so glad you could tune in today. Today we're going to be starting our series on the three C's. Let's go find out what the first C is.
Let's go.
Revolution somehow. Let love explode and bring the day to life. Love so bold to bring a revolution somehow. No, I'm lost in your
Good morning, Next Gen. Teacher Ryan here, and today I have with me
Kylie
and Brooke.
And today I have a task for you guys, okay? You see the table here? See how we have it all nice and set up, nice and organized. Spoon, knife, fork, plate, bowl, cup. Nice and beautiful. So I want you guys to take a look at it, memorize it, and see exactly how we have everything, okay? Let me know when you guys got it down, when you think you have it down.
Okay, I think I'm good.
You think you're good? All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna break it down. We're gonna disorganize it, okay? So if we can just organize this real quick. That's how you do that. All right. So now I'm gonna have you guys recreate it. You think you can do it?
Yeah.
But one thing that I'm gonna add to this to make it a little bit more challenging is you're gonna have to do it with these on.
Wow.
You got this?
Hopefully.
And then not to add to the pressure, but I'm also gonna time you guys as well.
That's a lot.
Give me one more video. I'm a little old in my age, you know, I don't know how to use these things anymore.
About 10 minutes later.
Right. All right, you guys ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go. No pressure. We got 15 seconds. No pressure. Oh, just to remind you to the candle.
I'm
going to watch out.
Wait.
Look at Kylie over there. Get it in, baby.
Oh, whoops, I
messed
up.
You guys tell me when you think you're done, okay? Minute 54 seconds. I'm actually quite impressed. That's really good considering the fact that you dropped the knife. But
it wasn't as long as you didn't drop the knife.
But I'm actually genuinely impressed. And so the whole point of this was, even though it's something that seems easy, it was difficult because there was things holding you guys back, making it challenging. And that's what the mitts were, is making it challenging. And the same thing for us going forward with our vision. I'm pushing our vision forward and reaching the inner cities and reaching the treasures of darkness. We have challenges, but you guys came together as a community, just like we come together as a community to reach those treasures. And that's what the same thing here was to come to show that we can come together to accomplish the task that has been given before us. You guys have a great service and see you next Sunday.
Next Gen, welcome to Kidz Cast. I'm your host, Brooke, with my co-host,
Kylie.
And today we have
Rocco
and Rosie.
Hi, kids.
And today we're going to be learning about our first C, and that is community.
Let's listen and open our hearts to what God wants to speak to you today.
The word community means a group of people who live or work together and have a common goal or belief.
Did you know that Victory Outreach is a worldwide family?
We are a community of people who believe in the same thing and have a common goal.
Even though we live in different parts of the world, our common goal is to reach the treasures out of darkness.
Yes, we need to bring the people the gospel, the good news of God's heavenly kingdom.
In Philippians 2:2-3, it reads, "Then make me truly happy by agreeing wholeheartedly with each other,
loving one another and working together with one mind and one purpose. Don't be selfish and don't try to impress others.
Be humble, thinking of others instead of yourself."
Can you think of a personal experience of a family gathering? where you had invited friends and church family? That's awesome.
Children, how would you describe a family?
A family just doesn't have to be a mom or dad or grandpa or grandpa, or not even just siblings.
Maybe you don't even have a family, but that's the exciting thing about our church. We are all brothers and sisters in Christ.
Guess what, Next Gen? That makes us a family of God.
The Bible says that as a family, they love four things, and that is...
They love listening to the pastors preach and teach God's word.
They love to fellowship. That means spending time together, laughing, talking, and even making each other smile.
Sometimes even crying and helping each other when we are going through hard times or even in sickness.
They love to eat together. It was special for them to have food and enjoy each other's company.
It would be like a big family eating together at a big table. Maybe they've had a special table setting.
They also love to pray together. They were excited to get together as a family and talk to Jesus.
Were they all related? No, but they were all part of the same community and like a family.
What do you think a church is? A church is not just a building with a cross on it.
Victory Outreach is not just a church, but a place we call home and a people we call family.
When we describe our family, it's about our mom and dad, brothers and sisters. We describe them the way they look and what they mean to you.
Our church Victory Outreach is a big family all over the world. That means you have brothers and sisters all over the world. Our job is to serve God together and love one another and make this family bigger.
We all serve one Father, and that is our God. We need to continue to pray. Pray to make each other stronger.
That is amazing how we make one big family. Rosie, can you please say a prayer?
Yes. Can you please bow your head and close your eyes? Father God, we thank you for our church Victory Outreach. Thank you for loving us so much and giving us our family and our church family. We thank you that we can always be a support to one another. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hey, Next Gen, Teacher Sam here, and today we have...
Teacher Ryan.
To help us out with craft. So as you guys all have your little craft bags there, open those up. And as you can see, we got a bunch of popsicle sticks inside. A bunch of colorful popsicle sticks. Ooh. Not just the plain brown ones. You like colors, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So they're all the same. All of them are the same, except they all have some Velcro on it. They all have Velcro, except for the red one. It's on opposite sides, but that's done on purpose, so don't try to fix it to match the rest of them. And the yellow one has double the Velcro. Super lucky.
Ooh.
Super blessed with Velcro there. Oh. All right, and so those ones we're gonna use kind of second to last. We're gonna save them towards the end. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna build a house. Hopefully Teacher Ryan's good at building houses, all right? So you're gonna get your sticks, and you know, to start off on a house, you gotta make sure you have the bottom, your base, your sidewalls, you know, and so you're gonna stick them together, and all the Velcro stick, one side's soft and one side's really pokey, you know, and you just kind of match them up like Teacher Ryan here. Once you get your square, will you hold it up?
I sure will.
All right, and we're gonna want the yellow one on top because it has double the Velcro, remember? Because we're gonna put a roof on this. All right, so now go ahead and throw your red one, and that's why the red one's a special one on top too, with the opposite Velcros to make it match. And we're building a house because we learned about community today. And as a community, you know, we're talking about family and your family, community, and church family, like me and Ryan right here. And now we got our little house. So you guys take pictures, post your houses, maybe build another house, upload it, but that's your colorful house. Hang it somewhere and tell everybody else about your family, your church family, and tell them about the community and what you learned today. Thanks, see you next week.
Hey Next Gen, Teacher Jolene here with today's Kids Gang illustration. As you learned today, we're talking about community, and community is family. And so each one of us comes from a different kind of family. Some come from a mom and a dad, some come from a family that has maybe your grandparents, or you're being raised by aunts and uncles, or, you know, we come from many different kinds of families. And I drew my family. You can see it here. There's me and Pastor Dave and my kiddos. And all these guys up here are part of our family. They're the men's home, our victory homes. So it doesn't matter what your family looks like. It can be small, just maybe you or one of your parents, or you have a big family like this. But each one of us comes from a different kind of family. We have our physical families, which is our blood family, and our spiritual family, which is our church family. So we just want to know that it doesn't matter what your family looks like, we all are together. We're one body of Christ. God created us all, and you're part of our family. And so I want to challenge you guys to draw what your family looks like. It can be big like this, or it can be smaller, but each one of us has a family that God gave us. And so I challenge you guys to draw your family and to take a photo of it, upload it to our Facebook page or Instagram, and tag VOABQ_NextGen. I can't wait to see what you guys have.
Wow, Next Gen, that was a great service about...
Yes, of the first seed about community.
Make sure to tune in next time. And don't forget about your kids challenge.
Bye, kids.
Bye.